Hey folks, today we're just chimping on Just Piddlin Barbecue. Now yesterday when I pulled into the carport after getting home from work yesterday, there was a beautiful box under my carport and it said Chimp on the outside, Grilla Grills. And I was as happy as I could be. So now I'm gonna do a review of this Chimp. I'm gonna do a little bit of comparisons of other tailgaters. And then I'm gonna go over the features of this tailgater. And this just may be the best tailgater as far as a pellet grill goes that you can buy. Or is it? Stay tuned. Now let me say this real quick before we get started. We are inside and it's a little echoey in here, but it has been a miserable day for rain. We've had tornado warnings at school today and it's fixing a storm again. The wind is kicking up 20 miles an hour out there, so we're actually inside where I do all the Just Piddlin merchandise stuff and all that. So it echoes a little bit in here, but we'll just have to make the best of it. Now, a while back, I did a review of the Traeger Tailgater that I have. And it was an honest review. There's a lot of things that I liked about it. There's a few things that I didn't like about it, and I pointed those things out. And I'll put a link in the iCard above so you can check that out and kind of see what I thought about the Traeger Tailgater. I was thinking that if I'm going to do a review on this tailgater, I should tell you guys how it compares to other tailgaters out there, because sometimes it's hard to actually get your hands on other similar grills that you're looking at. So I did some homework, wrote down some things to kind of compare all of these other ones, and I'll kind of go down the list a little bit and give you a little comparison. I'm actually glad that we're inside because it's raining sideways past the window right there, so I guess that was a good decision. Let's start off with price. I'll go from the lowest price up to the highest price, and the grills that I did my homework on are the Green Mountain Grills Davy Crockett, the Traeger Tailgater, the Camp Chef Pursuit 20, and the Rectech Trailblazer. And then also, of course, the Chimp. The cheapest out of those is the Davy Crockett. And again, you may be able to find it cheaper somewhere else. I looked on the actual websites of these grill companies and all that stuff, and I know that if I get something, no matter how minute, wrong, somebody out there is going to point it out, but this is as accurate as I can get. Davy Crockett comes in at $329, the Traeger Tailgater $449, the Camp Chef Pursuit is $524, the Chimp's $529, and the Rectech Trailblazer is $599. So that's kind of a price comparison. You go from $600 all the way down to about $330. Also with that though is that the square inches are really comparable to the price. The smallest square inch came with the Davy Crockett, which was the cheapest, and that has 219 square inches. That's what it said on the site with a 9-pound hopper. The Traeger Tailgater has 300 square inches with an 8-pound hopper. Camp Chef Pursuit has 501 square inches. That's with the top and bottom racks combined, and that's a 10-pound hopper. The Trailblazer from Rectech has 340 square inches and a 15-pound hopper. And the Chimp comes in at 460 square inches, total top and bottom, with a 15-pound hopper. So that kind of compares price, square inches, and hopper size of those grills. There's a lot more things that I have written down here for each one, but I think the video would be way too long if I go through all of those. So I'm just gonna hit some points that stood out for me. One of the things that stood out was that the two highest priced tailgaters, which was the Rectech Trailblazer and the Chimp. The Trailblazer, by the way, on the website, they really don't call it a tailgater. But that's the closest thing that I saw at this time to a Tailgater for Rectech. They're the only ones, as far as I could tell, that have stainless steel internals. This also has a stainless steel lid. So that obviously adds to the price of the grills. One of the other things that stood out to me was the weight of the grills. The Davy Crockett from Green Mountain Grills, it came in at 57 pounds. Traeger Tailgater is 62 pounds. The Camp Chef Pursuit weighed in at 82 pounds. The Trailblazer from Rectech weighed in at 80 pounds. And then you have the Chimp that weighs in at, I believe, 90 pounds. But the box actually said 102 pounds. I'm not sure if that's with or without the packing, but somewhere between 90 and 100 pounds. So this thing does not lack build quality. Two more things that really stood out to me was the height of these grills with the legs extended. What I have found so far with Tailgaters is they are really low and really not very pleasant to cook on if you're cooking on them with your legs extended. The Davy Crockett was only 31 inches high with the legs extended. The Traeger Tailgater is 36 inches, 3 feet with the legs extended. The Camp Chef Pursuit was 32 inches. The Trailblazer was, I don't even think I wrote that one down, but the Chimp comes in at 41 inches high, which is the highest out of all of them. And I think that's a big deal, because if you're flipping burgers or something like that, you're out tailgating, you're camping, the last thing you want to do is be bent over while you're cooking, flipping burgers, doing hot dogs, or anything else that you're cooking. And so this thing's going to be more comfortable as far as cooking wise with the legs down than the rest of them, because it's taller than the rest of them. The other thing, and this was the biggest thing for me, is you can barely find any videos whatsoever online that shows any of these grills with somebody extending the legs by themselves or putting the legs back in by themselves. The Traeger Tailgater, for example, I own it, and it is a nightmare for one person to put the legs down and to put them back up. I mean, it's a nightmare. Whoever invented those legs have never put them up by themselves, or they would never have come up with that concept. And it's kind of a universal thing. Everybody makes a tailgater with legs, but it's like the last thing they thought about was how somebody out camping or out tailgating is going to put these legs up and down. And so I'm fixing to demonstrate for you how the legs on this Chimp comes down and gets put back up. All right, the first thing I'm going to do is extend the legs, show you how you do that. And you just stand it up on the hopper end, pick it up. That leg snaps into place. Push that button in. That leg snaps into place. That's it. Come around to this side. Grab this sturdy handle. Push that button in. Snap it into place. Snap that one into place, and you're ready to go. That's it. And one of the things I also want to bring up is there are feet on the bottom that are adjustable, and they screw up or down to adjust and make it even. So if you wanted to leave it on your tailgate, on a table, or anything like that, you can do that without extending the legs by using the feet that are on the bottom. Now, what makes this such a great tailgater, in my opinion, is the attention to detail. If I were going to make a tailgater, it would be the Chimp. And really, just about every single thing that I hit on that I would change on the Traeger Tailgater, for example. And I'm not knocking Traeger. I've got three Traegers out there. I love their grills. But I mean, I'm just being honest. I would have changed several things on the grill. Just because It is what it is. It is a tailgater. It is meant to go camping. It is meant to be outdoors. It is meant to be tailgating. It is meant to be transported from point A to point B. And with that being said, keeping that in mind, there are certain things that you need. There are certain things that you don't need. There are things that you need to consider. And sometimes with some of these grill companies, I have to ask myself, these engineers may have degrees, but are they actually using the products that they're building? Because if they were actually using them, they would have changed a lot of things. I'll give you some examples. One of the things that I would have changed with several of the tailgaters is their exhaust system. Now, Camp Chef, I think, does have a smokestack, but it's got slots where the screws are so that they can be loosened, and you can kind of slide that smokestack down so it's not sticking up. To be honest with you, I don't really want to have to do that every time I want to transport my tailgater. The other ones, I don't believe, have a smokestack at all. But the placement of the holes for the smoke to come out was not thought through very well. The Traeger and the Rectech both have big holes on the top back side of the barrel. And I've experienced it myself. I just experienced it at Bristol Motor Speedway a couple of weeks ago. We took the Traeger tailgater, and it did an absolute awesome job all weekend. It was a workhorse. But the day that we had some rain, we ended up having a flame out because even though we had it under a canopy, mist and rain goes straight in through those holes, right into your grill. And it's just a bad design, in my opinion. Rectech is almost identical to that as far as the exhaust goes. Now, with that being said, Chimp has fixed that problem. Grilla Grills has fixed that problem. They don't have a smokestack, which I like, but they have put the exhaust on the end away from the hopper, and I'll slide this around this way so you can see. Right here on the end. Number one, they're small. And number two, they're on a vertical surface. So this is going to prevent water from entering these holes as much as possible. And I really like that design. Whereas the Traeger and the Rectech have the holes on the top back part of the barrel where rain can go right down in through there. Moisture, dew if it's sitting out at night, those kinds of things. So this is great. The other thing about this is, this thing is truly a mini version of my Grilla Silverback out there. The build quality, everything is very similar to that Silverback out there. And the reason why I like this is because naturally on the Silverback, the smokestack comes straight out here. So it's still on the exact same end as it would be if it was the grown-up Silverback. But now it's just on the end without the stack, but that's still where the exhaust is. And I really like that, and I think it's going to cook very similar to that Silverback. Other things that are really attention to detail and it really matters, or things that I mentioned on other tailgaters that I would have changed. They have a clip right here for the grease can to clip on so it's not going to fall off. Again, a convenient attention to detail. Something else that I had mentioned was the latch that is on this hopper lid. All of the tailgaters should have that. If it's being transported in the back of your truck and the wind catches this thing and now it's bouncing up and down and you get a little bit of mist or rain in the back of your truck, you're getting mist and rain into your hopper, and you know that that's one of the biggest enemies of pellets for a pellet smoker. Plus it just helps wear and tear on your grill if you have that latch that you can latch down and know that that's secured. The other thing that I mentioned was sturdier handles. You know, just because it's a tailgater doesn't mean that it can't be substantial, that it can't feel solid and sturdy. And you know, this whole thing, this lid is really identical, a copycat to the Silverback lid, which is very substantial. So if I have it in the back of my truck and I'm going to strap it down with ratchet straps, for example, I don't want to be scared that I might dent my lid, because it's so flimsy, with a ratchet strap. I want to be able to crank it down a little bit to make sure that it's not going to go anywhere, and I know that I'm not going to do any kind of damage to this with any kind of ratchet strap, rope, etc. Another thing that I really think that they got right was the hopper size. A couple of the other tailgaters only have 8 or 9 pound hoppers. Now, if you've been cooking on a pellet smoker full size and it has an 18 or 20 pound hopper and you've been cooking on that pretty regular, you get used to that. If I fill up my hopper out there and it's a 20 pound hopper, I can cook as long as I want to cook and never have to worry about checking it. So if I get used to that, and trust me, I've experienced this as well, I'm not used to cooking in a hopper that's only 8 pounds. So I have to remind myself when I'm tailgating with a tailgater that only has an 8 pound hopper, I need to go check it about every 30, 45 minutes, something like that, just to make sure it's not getting too low, it doesn't have a void or something like that, so that we don't have an issue. This hopper is only 5 pounds less than what my Silverback is. 15 pound hopper. That is big, because that cuts down on worrying about running out of pellets. You can chill out, relax, enjoy the tailgate, enjoy the camping, do other things besides having to worry about the level of your pellets. Now let's talk about some of the internals. Again, it was all about attention to detail and thinking about what are some of the problems that we have and how can we fix them. One of the first things that I kind of noticed, that really one of the only things that I kind of questioned when I got my Silverback, was the fact that when I put my grill grate inside, when I started to clean it with a brush or something, it would slide back and forth. They have fixed those kinds of issues with the Chimp and the newer Silverback. The first thing they did was they put a little tab right here in front of the RTD so that when that grate, if it slides back and forth, that it's not bumping into the actual sensor itself. So that protects that. Also, they have tabs back here in the back so that when you slide your grill grate in, it goes under that tab and keeps it from bouncing around. That's especially important for a tailgater. Again, if you have this tailgater in your bed of your truck, you're going through rough terrain, you don't want your grill grate bouncing around inside your grill. Along with that, when you put your grill grate in there, it goes under the tabs. It also has this bar on the lid. And when you close your lid, that bar actually goes on top of your grill grate in the front. So now the back part of your grill grate is under tabs, and the front part of your grill grate is under that bar included with the lid, so that it's holding your whole grill grate down. There's not going to be any rattling, any damage to the internals of your grill from your grill grate bouncing around. Again, those are attention to detail. It's all stainless steel interior, inside fire pot, stainless steel. There's your heat deflector. Beautiful, heavyweight stainless steel. I mean, it's beautiful. The drip pan, again, extremely heavy, stainless steel, all the way around, beautiful. Grill grates, top grill grate, and one of the things, again, attention to detail that I really like about this grill grate is it has the lip on the back, so that when you go to scoop something off, say you've got burgers on the top, and you go to scoop it off with a spatula, if the burger slips, it's not going to be up against the barrel of your grill because of this bar. Those are the little things that makes a good grill end up being a great grill. And then, of course, you have your regular grill grate. Again, stainless steel, very thick, very well built. So you combine all of those things, all the little attention to detail, stainless steel everywhere, very sturdy, very well built, very well thought out. The legs that are as easy as they can be to put up and to put down by yourself without any help. But there is one other feature that we haven't covered yet, and that's the controller. All right, now this is the new Alpha controller from Grilla Grills. It also comes on the Silverbac. You can also get it for the old school, the original Silverbac and the Grilla. But this comes standard on the Chimp, which again is awesome. Now what's the difference? What does this offer over the original controller? A lot of people have complained about wanting a PID controller because a PID controller is more accurate. They feel like it holds temps better. And so, you know, there's been two schools of thought as far as that goes. One, the PID keeps a more steady temperature. Or the other guys who think that the swing is good because you get a little bit more smoke flavor. Well, Grilla Grill has solved that problem without doing away with one of those groups, and that is to combine it into one single controller. So now you have a mode button right here. And depending on what you're cooking, depending on what you feel like doing that day, you can switch between PID or regular Pro mode. The Pro mode is going to give you more of a swing up and down. It's going to give you a little bit more smoke on your food. PID, however, is going to be more of a gradual, steady temperature. Why would you want to use that? For me, I have done breads, I have done cakes, and those kind of things using my pellet smoker for more of an oven. That might be an issue where you would want to go to the PID mode. Otherwise, if I'm doing a pork butt and I really want that smoke flavor, I want to get some more smoke, then I'm going to want to swing where it's going to dump some more pellets into that fire pot. And so I'm going to go with the Pro mode. So this has solved the problem. I don't have to choose between one controller or the other because now I have both. It also comes with a meat probe that you plug in right here. And if you want to check to see what your internal temperature is of your meat, you just hit the probe button. It'll flash up here for a little bit and then go back off. And there's a little door right there that you run your probe through. So you don't have to use the lid, open it up and closing it, trying to do that. So again, great controller. It's a premium controller that you're not gonna find on another tailgater. So I know this has been kind of a lengthy video, but I just wanted to hit all of the hot spots, benefits, details of this grill, so that you're informed about it and you can make a better decision on what kind of tailgater that you would like to get if you're in the market for one. My final thoughts. I think if I were going to build a pellet smoker tailgater, this would be what I would build. This is exactly what I would build. I think it has everything that you need for a tailgater. And I think that they made the right decision when deciding to not put certain things on this tailgater that you don't need for tailgating. I think it's the perfect combination of what you need as a tailgater, and then they left out what you don't need as a tailgater. Is there anything that I would change? Yes, definitely there are some things that I would change. Number one, I can't believe it doesn't have a bottle opener. My tailgater would have a bottle opener. That's issue number one. Number two, sometimes a benefit can also be a drawback. And sometimes something that you don't include, you may be missing out on something, or it may benefit you. It just depends on your viewpoint. The weight of this tailgater for some could be an issue. You know that some of the tailgaters weight as little as 60 something pounds, and this one's all the way up to between 90 and 100 pounds. Would I change that? I would not change that. Why? Because just simply the build quality. This thing is going to be, the other tailgater that I use, it gets used and abused when I take it camping, when I take it tailgating, when I take it to NASCAR races and those kinds of things. It's out in the weather, it's going in the back of my truck, it's getting stuff packed on top of it. And I want it as well built as I can get it. Stainless steel internals, stainless steel on the outside. That adds weight, but it also adds longevity. It's gonna be there for the long haul. this may be the last tailgater that I ever have to have. And I'll put that into perspective. 90 something pounds. I also have a Watchman stove that's a tailgater, but it's more than a tailgater. It's a fire pit. It's all kinds of things. It's a multi-purpose fire pit / grill. But that thing is made out of 3/16 or 1/4 inch solid steel, but it only weighs 75 pounds. That tells you the steel, the amount of steel that has been put in to this tailgater. As a small tailgating pellet smoker, I don't think you're going to find one that's better built than this Grilla Grill Chimp. That's my honest opinion. I appreciate you watching. I hope this has been helpful. If this was helpful and you liked the video, please give me a thumbs up. If you're not a subscriber, I encourage you to subscribe to my channel. We do a lot of cool things, live streams and stuff like that. I also have a website, justpiddlinbbq.com, so check that out. I've got these signs that I make, different grilling signs and different grill sayings and stuff like that. Or if you would like to customize one with your name on it or something, just get with me and I'll make you one of those as well. Check those out, t-shirts. I'm going to have hats on there pretty soon, so check all that stuff out. We're doing a lot of great things on Just Piddlin Barbecue, and I appreciate every single one of you. Mark Graham, all you guys at Grilla Grills, thank you so much. By the way, Sandy, you know, she always sends a little note when you make a big purchase from Grilla Grills. It's a nice personal touch, ready, set, smoke. And one day, Cindy, I hope to get up there. I don't care if I see Mark or not, but I would like to meet you because you're the one that always sends me the nice notes. So there you go, guys. The Grilla Grill Chimp. Now I'm going to take it outside because it has quit raining. And I'm going to fire it up, do the burn-in, and then make some hamburger steaks as my first meal and see how it cooks. I'll let you know how that goes. I'll post some pictures on Instagram. Check me out on Instagram and Facebook. And until next time, I'll be chimping on Just Piddlin Barbecue. Now I'm telling you, this is probably one of the easiest tailgater grills as far as putting the legs down that you're going to find. My buddy Chad Roberts, he's got a tailgater as well, and one night he calls me up and I can hear, it sounds like somebody is beating a piece of sheet metal with a sledgehammer, and he's fighting with his Traeger tailgater trying to get the legs down. He's out of breath, he can't hardly talk, he's saying a few choice words, and I mean, it's just impossible almost to put those legs down. So another thing that stood out to me was all right, so when it's in the portable, when it's in the portable,